wall that juts out towards the falls from the bridge. Please be careful if you're going to climb onto the wall, as it's often wet and mossy. Access to the falls is down a steep, muddy, and bit of a scary drop. Actually, I don't recommend doing it, but walking to the bridge for a better look, definitely worthwhile.
I see the falls.
They're gonna be on your side.
Did you want out for that?
No, you can't really get off the road safely.
Wait, some folks would disagree with you.
There's that guy climbing the wall like you said not to do. And unless you find a spot over here where you can park, it doesn't seem like it's safe to walk either. So. Oh, that must be what he's talking about.
We saw some taro farms from high viewpoints over Kane and Wailua. The most common way to eat taro is when it's prepared as poi. The taro is believed to have a direct ancestral connection to the Hawaiians. The legend says that the Hawaiian gods Waikea, the Sky Father, and Homohuka Kalani, daughter to Papa, the Earth Mother, had a child. The first child was born in and died only after a few days. They buried the child near the house, and a taro plant grew from the grave, and they named the taro plant Halawanaka. Their next son was born healthy, and named him Haloa, after his elder brother. Haloa became the first generation of the Hawaiian people. Poi is made by mashing the baked or steamed taro into a runny purple liquid. Water is then added during the mashing again just before eating to achieve your preferred consistency. Poi can be described as one, two, or three fingers, depending on how many fingers you would have to use to eat it from a bowl. One finger is thick, three fingers, obviously.